snowbound, the sun that brief December day, by John Greenleaf Whittier. The sun that brief December day rose cheerless over hills of grey, and darkly circled, gave at noon a sadder light than waning moon, slow tracing down the thickening sky its mute and ominous prophecy, a portent seemingly less than threat. It sank from sight before it set. A chill, no coat, however stout, of homespun stuff that quite shut out. A hard, dull bitterness of cold that checked mid-vein the circling race of lifeblood in the sharpened face. The coming of the snowstorm told. The wind blew east. We heard the roar of ocean in his wintry shore, and felt the strong pulse throbbing there beat with low rhythm our inland air. Meanwhile we did your nightly chores, brought in the wood from out of doors, littered the stalls and from the mows, raked down the herd's grass for the cows, heard the horse whinnying for his corn and sharply clashing horn on horn. Impatient down the stanchion rose, the cattle shake their walnut bows, while peering from his early perch upon the scaffold's pole of birch, the cock his crested helmet bent and down his querulous challenge sent. Unwarmed by any sunset light, the grey day darkened into night, a night made hoary with the swarm and whirl dance of the blinding storm, as zigzag wavering to and fro crossed and recrossed the winged snow. And ere the early bedtime came, the white drift piled the window frame, and through the glass the clothesline posts looked in like tall and sheeted ghosts. As night drew on, and from the crest of wooded knolls that ridged the west, the sun, a snow-blown traveller, sank from sight beneath the smothering bank. We piled with care our nightly stack of wood against the chimney back. The oaken log, green, huge and thick, and on its top the stout back stick, the knotty forestick laid apart, and filled between with curious art the ragged brush. Then hovering near, we watched the first red blaze appear, heard the sharp crackle, caught the gleam on whitewashed wall and sagging beam, until the old, rude furnished room burst flower-like into rosy bloom, while radiant with a mimic flame outside the sparkling drift became, and through the bare-boughed lilac tree our own warm hearth seemed blazing free. The crane and pendant trammels showed the Turk's head on the andirons glowed, while childish fancy, prompt to tell the meaning of the miracle, whispered the old rhyme, under the tree, when fire outdoors burns merrily, there the witches are making tea. The moon above the eastern wood shone at its full. The hill range stood, transfigured in the silver flood, its blown snows flashing cold and keen, dead white, save where some sharp ravine took shadow, or the somber green of hemlocks turned to pitchy black against the whiteness at their back. For such a world and such a night, most fitting that unwarming light, which only seemed where'er it fell, to make the coldness visible.